Of course we can imagine something better. I mean, I don't think it would be utopia, but, you know, if we could get back to the capitalism characteristic of, say, Europe in the 50s and 60s and the US, 50s and 60s, only without the racism and the misogyny and with more attention to the environment, in my mind, there'd be no question that that would be better. And that's not even a hugely radical reform. I mean, I have colleagues, and I'm sure you're talking to them, who think about, could we vastly expand employee ownership, for example? Could we distribute ownership? Could we distribute capital? Could we imagine giving people, you know, a share in the economy and being then much more engaged? You know, simple improvements like, excuse me, could we take care of the environment? Could we make it expensive to dump carbon dioxide into the atmosphere and poison the ocean? Could we require that people treat their labor force like human beings and pay them a living wage? And would that bankrupt us? No, it would not. So absolutely we can do better. Now, I'm an ameliorist, an incrementalist. Everything I've suggested is basically either, as I said, you know, take us back to the 50s and 60s, only a little bit better, or kind of, no, let's just control capitalism. You know, sometimes I say the free market is amazing. Unparalleled source of growth and innovation and opportunity. I love it, but it's a tiger. You need to keep it on a leash. If all you have is the free market and you say, go, make profits anywhere you can, the tiger will eat the world. It will fish out every last fish, cut down every last tree, poison the skies, kill the people. So we need to find a way to put the tiger on a leash. But that doesn't seem to me impossible. We're a very smart species and we've done it before.